Hello everyone, I'm Aishwarya and you're watching Aishwarya Academy. In our last video, we have learnt about the equation of wave. And today, we are going to learn about velocity of a longitudinal wave in a fluid medium. If you like my video, please click on the thumbs up button. Do comment, do share, and don't forget to subscribe as I'll be posting more new videos so that you'll get notified. What is a longitudinal wave? The waves in which the displacement of the medium is in the same direction as the direction of wave propagation. The vibrations are parallel to the direction of wave propagation. Example, sound waves and seismic P waves. Only a longitudinal wave motion is possible in a fluid medium. When a longitudinal progressive wave moves in a fluid, the particles of the medium vibrate along the direction of propagation. This is a longitudinal wave graph in which y-axis we have pressure and in x-axis we have distance. The peak point above the mean position is called compression and below the mean position is called rarefaction. And the height of the peak from its mean position is called amplitude and the distance between the identical points is called the wavelength. If you remember, in transverse wave graph which we have discussed in first part of waves, in that we had the mean positions as crest and trough. At any instant, the particles are crowded as compression and spread out as rarefaction. Hence, there is a continuous variation of pressure along the direction of propagation. Now, let us derive an expression for velocity of a longitudinal wave in a fluid medium. Consider a long tube of cross-sectional area A. Let the longitudinal wave be moving in positive x direction along the length of the tube with the velocity v. Let m and n be two right plane sections of the tube whose positions before the wave passes. The right plane section m be at a distance x and the volume enclosed between m and n be a into delta x. As the wave passes, let two plane sections get displaced to positions m dash and n dash respectively. Let the displacement of section m be y and the displacement of section n be y plus dy by dx into delta x, where dy by dx is the rate of change of displacement with distance. Now, the increase in distance between two sections will be the distance between n and n dash minus the distance between m and m dash, that is y plus dy by dx into delta x minus y is the increase in distance between two sections. Increase in volume of cylindrical slope is the product of rate of change of displacement with distance into the original volume enclosed between m and n, that is dy by dx into delta x into a. Volume strain equals to change in volume divided by the original volume. As we know, the change in volume is dy by dx into delta x into a and the original volume is delta x into a. So, if we cancel these two terms, it will remain with dy by dx, which is our volume strain. If k be the volume elasticity of a gas and p be the excess pressure at section m, now, at m dash, the volume elasticity is given by volume stress divided by volume strain. Volume stress is nothing but force per unit area, which is pressure, and volume strain is dy by dx, which we have found out in our previous step. Therefore, k equals to minus p divided by dy by dx. The excess pressure at section m, now at m dash, will be given by p equals to minus k into dy by dx, which is our second equation. If the pressure gradient along x-axis is dp by dx, the excess pressure at n, now at n dash, is given by p plus dp by dx into delta x, which is our third equation. Now, substituting the value of p in equation 3, we get p plus dy by dx into minus k into dy by dx into delta x, which implies p minus k d square y by dx square into delta x, which is our fourth equation. The resultant pressure on the slice of a gas between m dash and n dash is p minus k d square y by dx square into delta x minus p. Here the plus p and minus p gets cancelled, so we remain with minus k d square y by dx square into delta x, which is our fifth equation. Force acting on the slice of a gas is given by F equals to pressure into area. Substituting the value of P, we get F equals to minus KD square Y by DX square into delta X into A, which is our sixth equation. If rho be the density of the gas, m be the mass of slice of a gas, and A be the acceleration due to gravity, then force F is given by mass into acceleration, where mass is the product of density into the volume enclosed. Now, F becomes rho into delta X into A into minus d square y by dt square, which is our seventh equation. Therefore, from equation 6 and 7, equating the value of force, we get rho into delta X into A into minus d square y by dt square equals to minus k d square y by dx square into delta X into A. Simplifying this, we get d square y by dt square equals to k by rho into d square y by dx square, which is our eighth equation. Here, minus and minus becomes plus, and delta x into a on both the sides gets cancelled. This rho from the left hand side, when it comes to the right hand side, it becomes the denominator of k. We know that the general differential equation of motion is d square y by dt square equals to v square into d square y by dx square. This is our ninth equation. Therefore, from equation 8 and 9, v square equals to k by rho, which implies v equals to root over k by rho. The above equation is the velocity of longitudinal wave through the gas. Thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, please click on the thumbs up button. Do comment, do share, and don't forget to subscribe, as I'll be posting more new videos so that you'll get notified.